This is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today I have a very exciting episode for you. It's another episode where I'm saving some seeds. I love to save seeds and share with you guys how to save seeds because seeds are the lifeblood of your garden. Without any seeds, you can't have any plants. Without any plants, you can't be eating any food. So save your seeds. Now what I'm going to cover today are some very special plants. These are three very special brassica plants. These are long-lived brassica plants. These are called tree collards and walking stick kale. So first, we're gonna talk about the walking stick kale and saving the seeds from the walking stick kale. So walking stick kale and tree collards are completely different. They're different plants and they're similar because they grow for a long time, but one actually goes to seed quite often, like almost every year, and the other one doesn't, or hopefully doesn't. So you can see here, here's a big walking stick kale. It kind of fell over a couple times. It's been here for several years, keeps growing. You know, when it does go to seed, it starts making these small leaves. So the leaves are pretty much, I mean, you can't eat some of these smaller leaves, not too scrumptious because they're just so small. But here's another plant where it did drop seeds last year and it came up. So this is another walking stick kale plant. And these have nice larger leaves. So this is not yet in the seeding stage of its life cycle. So as you can see, this is the stalk of the walking stick kale. This is a nice large diameter. I mean, that's probably at least like a 2-inch diameter, 2.5-inch diameter on that. And you know, you could actually dry these out and these could be used as walking sticks. So this is a long-lived style kale. I wouldn't necessarily call it a perennial, though it has been living here for several years. It's not as good as necessarily the tree collards that we'll see next. But you can see here, it's just a mass abundance of these seed pods. So what happens is the plant goes to flower and seed, or you could call that bolting. It bolts. When it bolts, it makes these flowers first. So these are the flowers. They look like this. Next, after the flowers come the seed pods. The seed pods look like this, kind of like little beans. Now these are immature seed pods, and it's very important that you do not want to harvest the immature seed pods. Your seeds are going to be immature and they're not going to be ready to basically germinate and grow into new plants. So we need to look for the mature seed pods. Now luckily enough, I have some immature seed pods and also mature seed pods on this plant because this plant just makes a lot of seeds and they all mature at different times. Just like people, when they mature, when they're going through puberty, they get, you know, they grow in different parts and different areas at different times. Some people will be bigger than others and grow different parts faster than others, etc., etc., etc. I do not need to explain more. Well, same thing with the plant. This plant, some of the seed pods will mature now, some will mature later. Everyone's just a little bit different. So once again, here's an immature seed pod. It's totally green. If we go over to this one, it's kind of like a little bit green, lighter shade green, turning a little bit brown. And if we look real hard and real close, we could even go down over in this area, and you could see they're even getting more yellow. Now the yellow ones aren't even fully mature yet. What we want to look for is we want to look for one that's actually kind of a tan color and dried out. So tan color and dried out. Let's see if we could find one over here. All right, here's one right here. This one looks pretty tan colored and dried out. So we're going to carefully clip this one off. And we're going to carefully get our seed collection bin, which is a best plastics collection bin. Carefully put this seed pod or bean looking thing over the collection bin, and you're just going to basically very carefully squeeze this apart, and it's going to split at the seam. And once it does split at the seam, some of the seeds are going to pop out. And so basically there's two halves to this. This is one half and here's the other half. So we're going to take off the other half here, and there are some of the seeds inside the seed pod. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then here's 8 stuck on there. So we're gonna just simply dump these into our little container, and now these are all seeds from my walking stick kale I can save for next year, and maybe I could even grow a field of walking stick kale with these seeds. So I've got a little bit more work to do. I gotta harvest some more of these seeds over here. You know, once again, you wanna do this very carefully. Now, when a plant is as important as a walking stick kale, you know, I'm very sure to take my time harvesting the seeds. Now, if this was like an arugula and it had so many seeds, and arugula is a fairly common plant, you know, I would just not really care, and I'd probably be a little bit sloppy, might lose some seeds. But with a plant like this that I care for a lot, and it's actually fairly rare, I'm gonna take some time to preserve and make sure I get all the seeds. Once again, here's another seed pod. Let's go ahead and open this up on the camera there. So you can see here, we're gonna open this up, and some seeds dropped out. That's one half right there. And we'll just poke these out here. And the other half, we'll simply open it up here, just like so. There's a middle section right here, just comes right off. So as you can see, there's two halves and a middle. All three of these go together to make the whole seed pod. So as you just undo the middle, and all the seeds will come out. Now, if by some chance you do harvest these seeds when they're still a little bit immature and young, you want to set these in a cool, dry place so that they could basically, firm up and harden up a little bit. If you collect seeds that are not quite mature and dried on the plant, they're going to be a little bit soft, and they may not save that well, or your germination rate may not be as high because they're not fully mature once again. So anyways, I have a whole bunch of these seeds now. Let's go over next to some more important plants that I'm saving the seeds from today. So next, we're over near my tree collards. Now, these are my purple tree collards above me. They're really tall, and you know, they're having a little bit of challenge with some white flies right now, and they don't like the summer when it gets too hot. But if you guys remember, I had one plant up here that actually did go to flower and seed, and here are the seeds on there. Now, these are very special seeds. You know, you rarely see tree collard plants go to seed, and actually here's some seeds that the pods actually split on the plant and drop down. So I'm going to be sure any sprouts that come up from down below, I'm going to definitely save those plants, because that's going to be tree collards from seed, and I'll be interested to see how they actually grow. We're going to take some clippers and carefully clip off the seed pods on the tree collards. And once again, nowhere else on any of my tree collard plants are they seeding. So this is really a rarity. These plants are only 2 years old. I have some plants in the backyard that are much older, and they've never seeded. So let's sit down and check out these seed pods and see if we can get some purple tree collard seeds out of these seed pods. So now I have a nice large tub to put these in, and I'm just gonna basically break open the seed pods and see if I get any seeds out. Oh, and there's all the little tree collard seeds. So these tree collard seeds are really rare, and I don't even know if these tree collards are true to seed or not, but all I know is that I've never seen tree collard seeds before, and here they are. And these guys are super really rare, so I'm going to be sure to take some time and care to get all these seeds out and save them if they're any good. So once again, I'm just breaking open these seed pods over the plastic bin so that all the seeds don't fly everywhere, because that's how nature works. Nature works as these seed pods dry in the air, they get dry and they crack open and seeds drop to the ground, so now there can be new plants. So we wanna, collect all these valuable seeds of the tree collards, because these are really rare. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and collect the rest of these and bust open the rest of these, and I'm gonna have a little packet of tree collard seeds. So I got all my seeds, sifted out all the hulls, and now we're gonna pour it into a plastic bag. Now the best way to store seeds are in a plastic bag. You wanna protect them from moisture at all costs. So here are about 100 of the tree collard seeds now in this Ziploc bag. And these are some rare seeds. So that's how easy it is to save the purple tree collard seeds, the one that truly rarely go to flower. Next, let's check out the green variety of tree collards that the guy told me never goes to seed, but he wouldn't guarantee it, and now they're seeding, just like the check is in the mail. So here is my green tree collards, or supposed tree collards, and you can see here, it's it's still leafing, producing a lot of leaves and offshoots on the bottom, and right at the top, it's gone to seed. All the seed pods are pretty much dried out. Some of the seeds have been dropping on the ground. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna carefully come below where it's been seeding, and we're just gonna cut the stem off, also called deadheading. very carefully. And once again, we're going to take this whole cluster of seed pods in our big bucket so that we don't drop any of these valuable seeds. So once again, you know the drill. We got all the seeds in our little container here. We're going to open each seed pod and make sure we collect all the seeds in our container. And then we're going to save them in a Ziploc plastic bag. So you can see here, we open this up and all these seeds just drop on the ground. So the seeds of the walking stick kale were actually quite large, and these ones are quite small. So that would tell me that these seeds are probably, or this plant is probably not the same as a walking stick kale, because these seeds are a different size. So at least I know this is not a walking stick kale posing as a tree collards. So I'm just gonna go ahead and bust open these and we'll see how many seeds I get in just a minute. So as you can see, I'm taking my time to make sure I get all the seeds out of the seed pods of my green tree collards. And that's because these seeds are very important to me, and I want you guys to remember that seeds are the lifeblood of every garden and every gardener. And even in nature, if there were no such thing as seeds, there wouldn't be as many plants on earth. Most plants reproduce by seeds, although there are other methods they do reproduce besides seeds, but seeds is probably one of the primary methods. And plant extinction can happen and is happening at an alarming rate, especially in South America, where we are devastating rainforests possibly to grow cattle or grow food for cattle. So I want to encourage everybody to save their seeds to spread genetic diversity of your tree collards or whatever you're growing. Take some trips to far off land and save some seeds from different places so that these seeds can get spread far and wide so we can have the most genetic diversity of the plants as we possibly can. So I'm gonna get back to saving the rest of these seeds, then we're gonna go ahead and bag them up and we'll show you the results. So I just got done sifting out all the seeds of my green tree collards, and I'm gonna bag them and tag them. So make sure you basically tag your seeds in the Ziploc bag. So put today's date, the kind of seed they are, because you know, in a year, maybe even a month or 2 months, you'll see like, what were these seeds again? And that would suck. So, you know, very easy to label it. Indelible marker right on the bag, real simple. Next, we're gonna carefully tap this container down, get all the seeds in one corner, and slowly pour them into the bag. All right, so there are all the green tree collards in the bag. So we didn't get a whole lot of those seeds, but probably a few more of the green tree collards than the purple tree collards. And I like to compare the seeds to see, you know, how they look different. And you know, they just look a little bit different. These ones are a little bit more green, those ones are a bit more black. And if we look at the walking stick kale seeds, they're even darker and larger. So these are the walking stick kale seeds, much larger. Next is the purple tree collards, which are kind of the most similar shade, but smaller. And then we have the green tree collards, which are even smaller and not even quite as dark. So definitely today was a good day. I'm going to bed a lot richer than I was this morning. And I don't mean in dollars, because if you really think about it, what is truly important in our lives? Is it all the money in the world? I mean, that's just deceased presidents on pictures on printed pieces of paper, and I don't even know if it's really worth anything. But seeds are what is really worth it. This is what makes life. I mean, these seeds here are literally perennial vegetable seeds that you can grow and eat and will feed you and your family every single day of the year here in a climate such as California, where these will grow year-round. So I'm definitely a richer man today, and I'm proud of it. So save your seeds. Grow some perennial vegetables so that you too can also eat every day of the year out of your garden. Once again, this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and keep on growing.